So in this video, we're looking at prescribed cable zones. So in other words, when we go into an installation and we see just light switches or socket outlets mounted in a domestic dwelling, we can't see the wiring system. Here, you could argue that this is practicing a wiring system that's maybe in a shed or a garage where it's completely on the surface, but actually, we're trying to simulate it as if this wiring system was going to be covered in the future by the plasterboard and plaster or just plaster. So the cables wouldn't be seen, they would be concealed. So with a concealed wiring system, it's logical that the cables must make their approach, in this case to light switches and to the consumer unit, in areas where we would not expect to come along afterwards and drill. So in other words, we would have the wiring system coming vertically down into the accessory or horizontally into the accessory, and likewise as we go down below vertically. So this cable would be sunk into the wall or covered over by plasterboard and plaster. It's logical then that if a light switch is here, it's decorated over, that we wouldn't come along and drill into the wiring system because we'd know there's a switch below. And that's how we should be wiring our wiring systems in domestic dwellings. So in the event of the customer coming on afterwards, they'd have a logical idea where the cables are, even though they're concealed in the wall. So they should come directly down into an electrical accessory, directly up into an electrical accessory, or horizontally into an electrical accessory. So there is an argument here we should have wired between this lighting point and this lighting point directly sideways. However, we took a more logical route of going straight up, routing it round and coming back down again. So it's important when wiring in domestic dwellings that our cable zones fall within the prescribed zones, so directly down or directly across into electrical accessory. There is an exception, however, the return of a wall. We have an area here which also we can wire within. From the corner of a wall coming out 150 mil, either way, or from the ceiling down 150 mil is another area in which we can have cables. So we could have brought the wiring system up, across, and down in an area that we believe wouldn't be drilled in the future. We cannot apply the same rule coming up from the floor, so we can't come up 150 mil off the floor and use that as a prescribed cable zoning because of skirting board being fitted. So we would nail and screw skirting board on, therefore we can't use that as an area. But we can use the return of a wall within 150 mil, wiring system can go in either way, and down from the ceiling, 150 mil, but not up from the floor, as stated in BS 7671. Let's see how that relates to an actual installation. Let's go into an installation where we can't see the wiring system and presume that we know where the wires are or cables, even though we can't see them. So moving on from the workshop, we've installed our first and second fix, simulating a domestic dwelling, but we've just clipped our cables to a wooden surface. We come into a domestic dwelling where all we can now see is the, in this case, twin socket outlet, and we cannot see any of the cables that go to that socket outlet. So we must now have an idea of where we believe the electricians installed those cables. So the prescribed cable zones laid out in BS 7671 say, when wiring to an accessory, it should either come directly into the bottom of the accessory, directly down into the top of the accessory, or horizontally into our electrical accessory, either side. There is a slight twist to that. We can, however, install our cables within the return of a wall within 150 mil. So it may have been the cables have been brought down here within 150 mil of the wall until they come horizontal with the socket outlet and then come straight across. That is all acceptable cable routes. With a wooden floor, which we've got here, I'd expect it to logically come from the wooden floor coming up to the socket outlet itself. However, it could have come straight down or straight across into the electrical accessory or used the gap here within 150 mil of return of the wall. Care must be taken that the electrical contractors install their cables within the prescribed cable zones of BS 7671. So when the cables are concealed, maybe chased into the wall or covered over by plasterboard, we have a logical idea where those cables are run. Another point of interest that we've covered in the classroom is the heights of accessories within a domestic dwelling. This socket outlet is installed that from finished floor level, it falls at 450 to the bottom of the socket outlet. It could be greater than that, but it cannot be less than that. This is in order to accommodate people of limited reach in domestic dwellings. So here we have a light switch screwed to the surface Okay, cables are buried within the fabric of the building, maybe chased, maybe under plasterboard. And again, they need to take a logical route to the actual accessory itself. The light is in the center of this room. I believe the cables will have come and be run down into the switch here. However, also the electrical contractor has taken a cable down for a room stat. So care when they were screwing their own electrical accessory to the wall that they didn't drill into the cables that were behind the surface. So they've got to take some care as well. However, it could have run horizontally into the light switch, even though it's unlikely, and it could have come up from the floor into our light switch itself. Remember also, from the ceiling, not the coving, from the ceiling down, we've also got a prescribe zone that falls within 150mm of the ceiling, and cables can be run in that area. We did say previously that we cannot do the same for coming up from the floor. So as we come up from the floor, we have the skirting board. The skirting board is screwed and nailed into place. The 150mm rule doesn't apply there. Only applies to return of walls or from ceiling, not coving, from the ceiling down 150mm, where again, cables can be concealed within the wall. The light switch also conforms to the building regulations that requires to accommodate people of limited reach. From finished floor level to the top of the light switch cannot exceed 1200mm. It can be considerably lower, all the way down to the lowest, which was 450, which was the bottom of the socket outlet that we set. Be ridiculous to have a light switch that low, but it doesn't have to be at the maximum of 1200. Could be, for instance, at 1000 meter high. But the switch has been installed in this domestic dwelling to accommodate people of limited reach, as is the socket outlets, within 450 to the bottom or 1200mm to the top. Our electrical accessories we're installing in a workshop also conform to that building regulation.